Summertime is the right time for heading to the beach, going to the lake, or sitting by the pool. And you can't do any of that without some music. In today's episode of Prisoners of Rock and Roll, we're talking about the best songs of summer. So open a cold beverage of choice, sit back in your beach chair, and turn up the volume.
Summer wind came blowing in from across the sea.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Prisoners of Rock and Roll, episode number 43. My name is Bruce Kramer, and I'm here at the mic tonight with my two very good friends and co-hosts, Ryan McCusker and Doug McCusker.
What's up, everyone?
Are you rocking out there?
Prisoners of Rock and Roll is sponsored by McCusker's Tavern at 17th and Shunk Streets in Philadelphia, and we are part of the Pantheon Podcast Network.
Nice.
We're back!
We are back after our hiatus.
We had a little brief hiatus of about 5 weeks. So.
Yeah, I think we all had something else going on. So, sure. You know, we took a little time off.
Yeah.
You know, listeners definitely noticed that we were gone, which was cool.
We did. We actually got a couple emails from some people or some direct messages from like people that like that aren't friends with the three of us that were just like, yeah. Hey, I noticed I haven't seen you guys in a while. Is everything okay?
Yeah, people at the bar were saying like people were like, oh, you haven't had an episode in a while. I'm like, man, it's summertime.
Right.
We're up, you know, living beach life, you know?
Yeah.
Bruce is very active during the summer.
Yeah man. You guys were too, man. You guys had a couple band gigs. Ryan, you went on vacation. You guys had a birthday.
Yeah.
My son graduated
from high
school.
Congratulations again.
Yeah, I was on vacation a couple times. I got in two car accidents while I was gone in the last 5 weeks. So we've been busy, man, but we've decided, you know, we were going to get the band back together and
here
make
we
sure
are.
we hit another episode. So
I missed you, Bruce.
Yeah, man.
I missed you guys too, man. Yeah. I said that was definitely the longest I've gone without seeing the two of you in 2 years.
That's amazing.
So let's go on record. How was the Motley Crue, Poison, Joan Jett, and Def Leppard show?
Yes. So how many episodes, man, did we talk about that was something that we were looking forward to?
Dude, before the that show happened before we started this podcast.
So, yeah, man. I have an interesting story. So the night before, I went to Flogging Molly.
Very
and
cool.
The Interrupters in Philadelphia.
Very cool.
And really, really cool. I was actually like almost up against the stage, and I was like, man, I haven't been up against the stage at a punk rock show
God.
In forever.
That was allowed.
It was. It Jeff wasn't. Plugs. There wasn't like a mosh pit or anything.
Did you have, like plugs in?
Your books? Yeah. No, I didn't.
Oh, good for you.
No.
Dude, we're old.
I should have
put that shit in.
But you know, my son caught a guitar pick.
That's great.
From Flogging Molly. Nice. So he was going nuts. But that night we got home and I was like, oh, cool. I'm laying in bed. It's late. And I pull up the Ticketmaster app to find my tickets for the show the next day, the Motley Crue show. And I was like, they're not in my app. And it says, we mailed them to you. And I was like, I bought those tickets 2.5 years ago. I have no friggin' idea where in my house those tickets are.
Yeah. Oh, so you had the actual tickets
they
in your hand.
They had mailed me tickets.
Wow, they actually had regular tickets rather than not
everything's
Apple
on the app now.
Yeah. I don't know where they
you
are.
You had hard tickets?
Yeah, that's...
But I never found them. I called Ticketmaster and waited on, and thankfully they issued them to my, I was like, dude, they're in my house somewhere. I know, I totally remember saying to my wife, I'm going to put these here so when I can't find them, but I don't remember what that here was.
You're fine, though.
You know what I did? I bought the cheapest ticket in the place.
So you had the greatest move of all time.
I hooked up with one of my friends, and he basically gave me a backstage pass for Motley Crue and Def Leppard, Poison, Joan Jett. I was like right up front, so I didn't want to like look like an amateur and take pictures and shit because I had the laminate on. I don't think I was supposed to be there. Yeah, I'm never supposed to be anywhere, but it was cool to see the crew like that close and Poison that close.
So we my family, we had tickets. We had, I don't know, tickets were $150 a piece. We got pretty decent seats.
Yeah.
And, you know, Ryan's like, oh, I bought a ticket. I bought the cheapest seat I could. I'm going to hook up with you guys later. And I was like, homie, we ain't sitting with the poor people, man. We got
with the peasants.
And then
aristocrats.
I'm a socialite.
I'm sorry. Yes.
And then when we get there, we get all settled in. I text him like the view of our seats. And then he texts me a picture of him wearing a fucking lanyard and the stage is 2 feet behind him. And I was like, how did you pull that off? He's like, I'm Ryan McCusker, baby.
My experience at the show, wait a minute, I worked the bar that night.
You were working
in the bar. So
you didn't really care about it.
I didn't really care. I'm good. I'm good.
I thought Joan Jett was good.
Yeah, she was awesome.
She was really good.
I saw her a few years ago. She blew my
She
doors
did
off.
Light of yeah. Day. How about that?
Did she have the video behind her?
I don't know. I was just too busy watching
her.
She
had a bunch of videos
Yeah, like
going.
From the movie. Because when I saw her a few
there
years ago.
There were some clips from the movie playing.
Yeah, I was like, get that. Get it. Hey, if I was in a movie.
I was like Joan Jett's 2 feet in front of me.
Yeah.
Like you see her plastic surgery.
Yeah.
She was great. I thought Poison was really good.
They brought it, man. I saw them on the Flesh and Blood tour in 91, and they haven't lost a step.
Yeah, I thought they were really good. They were really engaging with the crowd. CC DeVille was just awesome as always.
So did it, he in his guitar solo, he did an Eddie Van Halen
show. He did.
Yeah,
Eruption.
He did.
Yeah, I've seen the show, but watched the whole show on YouTube.
They had the logo of his logo on the screen of the guitar.
But he looks great though. Speaking of plastic surgery, new teeth, brand new hair, brand new everything.
We thought Def Leppard was not good.
They played a lot of new stuff, right?
This is what I've come up with. I think they have a deal with Motley Crue that Def Leppard cannot go up there and blow the fucking stadium up and blow Motley Crue out of the water. I think they have a brand new album out. They pushed the new songs. They had an acoustic set. Dude, they like totally pussied it down.
Yeah.
So Motley Crue, cause Def Leppard is a way better vocal band, better playing band, better everything band. They would go out and blow Motley Crue out every fucking night if they didn't tone it down.
And we said that every time we talked about this, we're like, Def Leppard's going to go and blow their doors off and
Holy
take them
shit.
Apart.
But, they took the back seat. Yeah. I'd noticed it right away.
So Anna went to the show and she had a great time, but then she flew to Charlotte, North Carolina to take our niece to the show out there. And at that show, Def Leppard closed the show.
We would have left. I think if they were playing that, man, and it was wrapping up, maybe that's why.
And she said they played all the hits. It was a completely different show for them.
Huh. Yeah. I'm telling you, they will not play a bunch of hits before Motley Crue comes on. Because it would be like...
Their ego.
I don't think Motley Crue's all that great. So how do you have a band that come out and blow the doors off? They're a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductees. Blow a lot of bands out of the water. Like
Def Leppard is a lot like AC/DC, where they've been writing the same song for 40 years.
So?
But it's a great song, man. Yeah. I think they're very. I think a lot of their stuff all sounds the same with the harmony. Don't get me wrong, man. It's a great song.
Yeah,
I was like, but play that song.
But you know, it's really funny. You know, Tommy Lee didn't play the whole show, and I'm like, hey, man, the guy who opened up for you, the guy who played just before you, only has one arm, and he's been doing it for like 40 years. Like, man up, dude. So, with him not playing the whole show, I was okay with not going. Cause
Bruce's kid thought I was backing up Tommy Lee. because he showed him the backstage pass. He's like, Ryan, is Ryan backing up Tommy Lee?
Of course he is.
Yeah.
No, he's supposed to be sitting in the cheap seats. And now he's in the front fucking row.
And then I thought Motley Crue was great, man. I think they were kind of propped up with the stage show and all the
Lights. You have to.
He sounded way better than the last time we saw him.
Three girl backup singers.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
They always had backup singers, but he needs it.
Three of them?
Yeah, he needs it. Yeah.
He has a teleprompter. They were breaking his balls about that in the last couple days. Who cares? Ozzy pisses his pants every night goes out there.
That's why he has the bucket of piss. Or a bucket of spit, whatever.
So I thought they were great, man. I stood the whole Motley Crue set.
Yeah,
I thought they sounded really good.
Yeah, Primal Scream was great.
Yeah,
Wild Side. Right when they opened up with Wild Side, man, the people behind me just went fucking apeshit and started throwing chairs.
Yeah,
really?
Oh yeah,
I turned into the '80s.
I just moved out of the way. I was like, I'm fragile.
There was, I guess we'll get into the topic at some point for tonight. But I was, I was sitting in my seat waiting for Motley Crue to come on. And I looked to my left and there's a foot snaking, like the seats at the baseball seat.
Yeah.
There was a foot kind of
Between seats.
Like under the seat next to me. And I turn around, this lady was so drunk and passed out. She was in the row behind me. But she was like crammed down between like the part where you sit on and where your feet go down at the bottom. It was almost like those old episodes of like Tom and Jerry where he turns into like liquid and he falls down the stairs.
Yeah.
They had to clear a whole row. They had to bring an ambulance to get her.
Really? She was like, the kids got a full experience of a Motley Crue show.
And they were in expensive seats.
Yeah, and then they got pictures. And then they got
the experience
of
show.
Me taking pictures of her.
Yeah. Like, hey, look at me. Dude, that place was a shit show, I'm sure.
Let me tell you, there was a lot of hurt-looking girls there.
Well, dude,
it was fucking hurt. There was a lot of, 80 queens, yeah, like the 80s. The
people that haven't been out since the last time Motley Crue toured.
And it was just like, holy shit.
Anna said to her nieces, like, same thing in South Carolina or North Carolina. It's like, there's a lot of nanas here dressed in spandex.
Yes. Like, yeah. You know, yes.
So, hey, at least they got out. They relived.
They probably looked awesome 30 years ago.
But, like, hey, good for everybody. Hope everybody had a good time. I hope everybody had a safe time.
It was awesome.
You know?
Did they have fireworks, Bruce?
They did.
Because I didn't see. I was up front. I was on stage.
Yeah, we could see the back of the poor.
Well, I'm serious. I was on the stage, and I couldn't see it, but I could smell it. I'm like,
okay. From where I was sitting at 17th and Shunk,
I could hear
the fireworks. Yeah. I'm like, oh, the show must be over now.
Yeah, it was cool. I said it was two concerts in 2 days for me. Was like, I mean, I haven't done that since before the pandemic. It was really, really cool.
Very good. You got to catch those shows, man. Like, I got Dead & Company this weekend.
Yeah,
I'm all
nice.
I think, you know, our show Summertime. I think concerts come along with Summertime.
Sure.
You know, that's when I get all my shows in. I'm seeing Dead & Company, and I'm seeing Fish 4 times in like a month.
Right on.
Yeah.
You know what, too, man? When I said we saw Flogging Molly, they had the Interrupters open for them. And I listened to them like a little bit.
Mm.
They were really good.
I don't really know who they are.
They were like, kind of like a punkish kind of, you know, a place.
Like something.
Yeah. I said that they were like a less shitty No Doubt.
They really suck.
I like
Here's
No Doubt.
Here's a song called She's Kerosene.
Yeah, these guys suck.
They got energy. I'm sure the energy was on stage.
What year is this?
It's probably new.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
It's new.
Hang on, I can look.
I don't think it's new.
That sounds like Jonas Brothers.
And they've been around for 10 years. They've been broken up for 10 years.
2018 this came out.
Okay.
I really enjoyed they were dancing the whole time. Yeah. It's like three brothers and her, and she was being really cool. You know what? I have one other thing, man, with the Flogging Molly was... I don't know if you guys have ever seen them.
Yeah.
They're like, I think outside of Springsteen, they're my favorite band to see live.
Sure,
because he just not stop.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know, and he comes out and he normally, you know, he comes out with a 6-pack of Guinness and he's like, oh, time to do a fucking beer.
He's Irish.
Off the boat. Yeah. He's from Ireland. He's got the real thick accent and he opens a beer and he's like, you know, the guy in front, he's like, you don't have a beer. So he goes and grabs a 6 and he's handing out the beer to do a toast. And there was a couple little kids in the front, like 8 or 9, like on shoulders.
Yeah, yeah.
And at one point, he stops his show, and he was like, hey, honey. He's like, let me get you a bottle of water. And he grabs the bottle of water, and he throws it to the dad. And then he, at the end of the show, the guy's leaving, and he does the whistle between the two. And the kid turns around, and he takes another bottle of water. He picked up the set list. He wrapped it on the bottle of water, and he threw it. And he was like, that's for your kid.
Nice.
I think it was really cool.
Yeah, now, I love when the art, like your these guys, you know, really give back to the fans.
Yeah, it was real personal.
Those kids were really cool.
Because he probably has kids, like, also.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? Or that at one time or whatever.
That will probably leave an impression to those kids for the rest of their life.
They're gaining fans for down the road.
Sure. And then another, like, well, I guess I have one more story that, they finish and they're, you know, they're throwing the drumsticks and the guitar picks. And this dude next to us looks like the punk guy you wouldn't fuck with. He's got the big aqua mohawk and the jacket with all the spikes and the pins. And he catches it, and then he taps my son on the shoulder and was like, hey, man, I saw you dancing the whole show here. You probably want this more than me.
Yeah.
And then I tapped him. And I was like, hey, man, it was really cool. Thank you. Yeah. I was like, and he's like, yeah, man, awesome.
Punk rockers are cool, man.
Yeah, man.
People look like aliens doesn't mean that they are. They're sweet
really,
people.
Really,
they're very intellectual. They're very kind, man.
Yeah, it was really cool.
I always say, man, the punk rock kids that come in my bar are more classy than a lot of people that come in my bar.
Yeah, I agree.
So
absolutely.
So yeah, man. But you said like summer, you know, going to concerts is all a big part of the summer thing and the outdoor festival stages and all that kind of stuff. You know.
Tunes come to mind when we say summer. Is like sitting on the beach.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Like that's most of my summertime. Like. Just sitting on the beach.
And that I agree also. Like, I'm not going to a lot of shows this year. I'm going to a Fish show, and I got Pearl Jam with Ryan down in September. But I'm totally cool with hanging down the beach, taking my time, my time that I have, and just going down the beach and just hanging out and listening to music.
Yeah, so you guys, I mean, you know, being in Philadelphia, we're an hour and a half, 2 hours from the beach, and what is it, like once a week, right?
You guys. Every Monday.
You guys
we
both,
try to.
You guys both go down to the beach and hang out. That's awesome, man. And I grew up getting a Shore House with my buddies every year.
That's awesome. I wish I could have done something like that. Yeah, we didn't
have anything like that.
It was a couple of the best summers of my life. Yeah. I probably wouldn't be able to do it now and hang at that speed. But it was, you know, I totally remember, man, getting out of work on a Thursday, driving down the shore, staying out all night, driving back up to work in the morning, and then going back down the shore.
When I had energy.
Yeah.
But you'll drive down here an hour and a half to do the show, which we love.
Right,
you
know? Yeah.
I mean, the East Coast has such a, people that don't know about our coast, very big shoreline through New Jersey.
Sure. Yeah. I mean, it's what what we're famous for, other than, you know, all the crap. And it's part of it is that god awful MTV show.
Yes. And, but we're like away from all that. We are like nowhere near where the Jersey Shore TV show was. That was closer to New York.
Yeah. I'm, like North Jersey. There. Like that's the beach that we like. Closest to us is that I've been on that beach. Yeah.
Yeah. How is it?
I've never watched 5 minutes of that show.
I've never seen it either.
But I mean, there's still like,
I
think
it's cliche.
Yeah. There's still crap on the boardwalk. Like here, you know, where.
But there's type of people exist everywhere. Hey man, those type of people exist right down the street from here.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. Right. So. Right. Right. Yeah. It's definitely a lot of yokas and it's a lot of New York people.
My favorite thing was that girl Snooki, and she calls herself a Guidette.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A Guidette. Like, you know, they call them Guidos.
Yeah, Guidos.
And she calls herself a Guidette.
They still
like
pop up.
Right, Rob. He's a Guidette.
we're going to talk about him a little bit later,
too.
We are. We got the warden coming up. But, yeah, man, there's songs that I think of when we were talking about this idea is some songs that are like, when I'm driving down the shore,
sure,
I want to listen to, because there's a lot of like, I mean, you can take highways, right? There's highways that go down to the Jersey Shore, but then there's also like back roads that are like through the Pine Barrens. Mm. You know, if you watched The Sopranos, there was that one episode where they were lost in the Pine Barrens. You can go.
That was great.
It was great.
Yeah, that was a great episode.
They could have had a TV show themselves. Just those
just like a buddy comedy show. Yeah. But there's like, you could take those back roads, man, and it's like, you know, it's one lane each way, and you can light up the gas, and it's okay. You can pass people and go, and it's just, you know, I think of like Fortunate Son by Creedence. Like
I was going to say like the Creedence.
Yeah, roll down the windows, man, turn that shit up, and just light it
running
up and
through
go.
The jungle
but,
and shit.
But, you know, I guess.
You travel a lot, dude.
Yeah.
Like, you know, so the summer's all road to you.
Yeah. Yeah. We're on the go a lot in the summertime. But, you know, and there's also songs for just sitting at the beach or sitting by the lake or sitting at the pool.
And that's what I see summer as. Like, I just got back from vacation. I was in West Palm Beach for a week. And the only thing I did was sit on the beach, drink pina coladas, and go to the pool and sit on my balcony.
There's nothing wrong with that at all. Yeah,
7 days of that.
Yeah.
And it was fucking awesome.
And you needed that too, man.
I went alone, and it was the best vacation I ever had. So future vacations for myself alone.
Let's talk about some of these songs. You know what? All right. So the first song I had on the list, man, it was that we don't really have an outline. We're just talking, but, you know, probably maybe one of the most famous for us in Philly, man, is Summertime by DJ Jazzy Jeff, man.
Like classic song.
You guys fans of the song?
I like this song a lot.
I like it too. Yeah. I think it's the last street credit Will Smith got.
Yeah, it's definitely his biggest money maker.
It's a hell of a rhyme.
Yeah.
I mean,
it pops out every June it starts coming around.
The thing about Will Smith that I always liked, he never cursed in the songs.
Except when he's at the Oscars, that's the only time he seems fucking curse
but
and slaps.
In the 80s and the 90s, he was just like clean cut. Like, I never watched that TV show that it was on.
Yeah. Fresh Prince?
I never watched
it. You watched Joe MT Raps, but you never watched Fresh Prince?
Motherfucker.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's play a little bit of it.
Drum roll, please.
Slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm, just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but
I'm sorry, go ahead.
What he talks about during the thing is basically his summer in the city,
right? Yeah. And it's all Philadelphia.
It's all Philadelphia. Me and Doug can like totally, you know,
relate to it.
Totally.
But like, here's the question. Now, that being said, do you think this song is popular throughout the rest of the country, or do you think they just all moved on? Like,
no.
This song is not popular
in
LA.
Everybody moved on.
Yeah.
I don't think it's popular at
all
anymore.
It's worthy to be mentioned considering where we're from and everything like that. But I honestly can go to the rest of my life whatever hearing that song.
Really?
Because, oh, absolutely. Because it pops off like every block. Yeah. Every block party there is, it comes on, and you know, it has a service and it has its place here in Philadelphia, but I could be okay without hearing corny ass Will Smith ever again.
I don't know if the block party is that a Philly thing?
Yeah.
No, it's a New York thing too. It's an urban thing.
It's an East Coast, like, you know.
Yeah, so those of you that listen to us and aren't in one of those areas, it's like the block party is like you can get a permit and you block off your street and everybody basically has a barbecue at the same time. People put the bounce houses in the street and the DJs and everything else.
Yeah, and it's great when they have like a one-year-old birthday party and they direct buses another way on a Saturday and people are like, they can't get home. Yeah, because there's a block party for a one-year-old.
Right. The block parties in the city are something you see. A lot of block parties people do are serenades, what they call. Yeah. It's when the husband or the groom serenades his future wife outside her house, and that's a big Italian thing.
Yeah, I never saw that one. I lived in the city.
Oh yeah, it's cool.
Yeah,
it's cool. It's romantic, I guess. You know, but you know, that's what I think summer is a lot of these block parties, and Will Smith, you know, totally captures the whole thing. You know, just playing ball, playing go.
Jumping in the fire hydrant. Yeah, you know, driving down South Street.
When he says "fresh from the bar, black from the beauty salon,"
turn around to see what you beeping at.
That's the shit.
Okay, the song I like during the summer.
Yeah,
is the Ramones "Rockaway Beach."
Okay,
it's kind of a cliche, but hey, you know that's something I like to hear.
Yeah, man, that's a good summer song. We can fire that up too. Here you go.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I listen to that.
We could be doing
December songs, autumn songs.
But like, here's another song. Here's the experience of these guys, what their summer's like, trying to get to Rockaway Beach.
Yeah,
like, you know, I mean, it's like still concept, like what their summers are like.
I think the Ramones have a big surf rock influence.
Sure. Yeah.
You know, surf rock in with old R&B, old rock and roll. That's the Ramones. You know. You know, it's my friend goes out to Rockaway, and they say there's nothing out there for the Ramones except for like a cutout that you could put your head in.
Oh, really?
That's weird.
Yeah, like here's this iconic song that you think you could like make vacations around.
Right.
You know?
I think George Carlin is from Rockaway Beach, too.
Is he?
Yeah, if I remember correctly. Funny. But yeah, it is funny.
But Rockaway Beach is the shit.
Yeah.
But I was supposed to go to Coney Island with a friend in a few weeks, but we had to cancel it because there's like the Cyclones out there, the minor league baseball team. Apparently, the Cyclone goes to the ballpark and all that. We're not going to wind up going because of scheduling conflicts. But like the same thing, there's not much there. Like there's on the weekends, it's kind of popping. They have
it's a beach. You go to the beach. Yeah, there's a little boardwalk.
There's a little boardwalk. Right?
Have you ever been?
I haven't.
I'm amazed that I've never been there. I'm amazed by this.
I am too.
You know, like I know they have that like the mermaid parade, and that's a huge deal. Like people come out in droves for that, and you got like Nathan's there and all that.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to get there one day.
I always wanted to go to Coney Island more.
Yeah, we talked about that at like the Shock Rock episode that it kind of like started there. Some of like the vaudeville.
Stuff
was all there.
Yeah.
I'm not a big fan of going into New York for anything, even though I live like I'm probably closer to New York than I am to Philadelphia.
I
don't want to go there.
I love it there.
But I would like to go, you know, someday check it out. You know. Maybe I got more time on my hands now.
At 46, I'm just amazed I've never been there, you know.
Yeah.
No, I mean I've had better destinations to go than Rockaway Beach.
No, I'm talking about Coney Island.
Oh, Coney Island.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to check it out. I saw it. So
yeah. I wanted Nathan's and Nathan's dog.
Yeah. You know, another, I guess maybe another local song would be, we talked about, he just passed away a couple of weeks ago, was Bobby Rydell.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. You know, Wildwood Days is, yeah, you know, Wildwood's a short town. That's the town you guys go down to, yeah, right? That's right.
They got a mural of them on the boardwalk.
Yeah. Yeah. You know? Yeah. That's the, you know, back in the day, man, we talked about this in the 50s rock too, that like Bill Haley used to play down there. Yeah.
There's a mural of them also down there.
Yeah, yeah. It was a big, like, rock and roll star. Music was a big thing. In
all those bars had rock and roll bands.
Yeah.
And they all just played until like 3 o'clock in the morning, whenever last call was. You know, Springsteen's famous for that.
Yeah.
You know, built making his bones by playing all those Jersey bars down the coast, and down the coast.
And the Jersey Shore sound is like, it's a thing, right? And there's still bands that are around, like Southside Johnny or other artists that have that sound.
But we know guys that play that circuit, man. Like, you know, we like to play at a bar with like a bunch of musicians and things like that. And a lot of guys are not available because they're all down the shore.
Down the
shore. Working, man, like steady working, like killing it.
Sure. Yeah. Sure. Let's play a little bit of Wild Wild Days, man.
Bobby just passed away, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he was. Yeah,
last month or two, a little bit. Here's a little bit of it.
All right.
Spring will soon be gone.
Wildwood Days.
Summer's coming on.
Wildwood Days.
Now I'm dreaming of
Wildwood Days.
Lots of summer love. All I think about
Wildwood Days.
After school is out.
Wildwood Days.
Head down the shore.
Wildwood Days.
Have a ball once more. Whoa, 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 whoa. Those Wildwood Days.
Dude, it was a huge song, man. Holy shit. Dude, that was a huge song.
They still play that on the boardwalk.
It's every day.
Every day. They make an announcement all day long.
Yeah.
You want to jump off the boardwalk, dude.
No, it's awesome. It's a happy song. I love happy shit, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just love it.
It's like, oh, let's go get some Sam's Pizza, or let's go get some Douglas Fudge. Summer, all right. There's like
the summer's supposed to be that sound.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Sure.
You know.
It's like 9 o'clock and like the sun's like kind of still up a little bit, man, and you're just on the boardwalk and all the carny shit's going on and
you got a little sunburn.
Yeah.
Maybe you gotta put a hoodie on because the little breeze is coming on.
It's good stuff, man.
And Jersey Shore boardwalk pizza, there's nothing better.
Sam's, dude.
The slices are enormous.
There's endless names of great pizza down the Jersey coast.
We'd probably clarify that too, you know, around here we're talking about beach songs, but you know where we are, it's you go down the shore.
You go down the shore. But it's actually going up.
Right. Even if you're going north, it's still down the shore.
Down the shore.
You know, it's like
somebody asked me in the bar, I guess you'd call him a transplant, and he was just more like, what does that mean, go down the shore?
Yeah.
I mean,
really?
I didn't know how to explain it, but to tell him you're going down the shore.
I said something last night to a couple of guys that were from South Carolina. They stopped in, they're truck drivers or whatever. They had a company. And I'm like, downtown. He's like, well, isn't this downtown? I'm like, correct, sir. I mean uptown, because we're like deep south.
Right, so
it's always downtown.
Yeah, or like that. I mean, that's like Jersey Girl from Springsteen. Is down the shore, everything's all right. So,
totally. I mean, there's endless, countless songs about summer.
Yeah.
So, speaking of Mr. Springsteen, do you have a summer Springsteen song?
I do, and I was just gonna fire up Jersey Girl, but I was like, nah, you know, it's a Tom Waits song, and the song that makes me think of it, man, is Fourth of July, Asbury Park.
Okay.
Sandy.
Okay.
Great
song, great album.
Sandy, the fireworks are hailing over Little Eden tonight. Forcing a light into all those stony faces left stranded on this warm July. Down in town, the circuits fall a switch, played lovers so fast.
His words are great, dude.
Yeah.
He's like an artist with his words, like
absolutely.
A painter. Like
he
paints a scene. With his words.
Yeah. I mean, it's a long song. It's like 5.5 minutes long.
Yeah.
It's kind of slow.
Yeah. But still, the words are great.
Dude, you could sit on the beach and listen to that song and
fucking daze out and stare in the ocean for.
I mean, and the place, like, you know, they finally busted Madame Marie for telling fortune better than they do.
Yes.
Like, that place is still there. Like, you can go to Asbury Park and it's
Is it a big tourist trap?
I think I've never actually seen anybody go in.
Oh, really? Yeah. Even though it's mentioned in the song?
Yeah, it's there.
That's crazy. Yeah. I think when I was there with you, you pointed it out to me.
Yeah.
I was like, oh.
Yeah.
I would be surprised if it's a little tiny Yeah, but it's still mentioned in the song. Like, you're like, oh, shit.
I'm sure there's Springsteen Pilgrimage.
Absolutely. Hardcore fans. Fucking,
sure. It's almost across the street from the Stone Pony where he cut his teeth coming up. And, yeah. You know, that's like, I mean, that place has got insiders all pictures of him every time he would show up. And he's still famous for, like, you know, there's a bar down the street from the Stone Pony that he'll sit in there and watch a Giants game on a Sunday drinking a beer, eating a burger. Or he'll show up at bars down there and just get up on stage and play with the house band for 3 hours. And it's just like, it's awesome.
Hopefully he will play the U.S. soon.
He will be on the road next year.
But he'll be in Europe.
He's in Europe. Yeah. He said he's going to start in the States, then he's going to go to Europe, then he's going to come back to the States for the summer. Then he's doing Australia, New Zealand, and then he said he's going to come back. So it could be a two or three year tour.
Yeah. I think if we don't see him inside during the winter, we're going to see him next summer, definitely.
Yeah, I think you're going to get both. I think he'll play the inside, and then he'll probably do a couple days at Citizens Bank Park.
That'd be great.
Where the Phillies play. So I'm excited. I was on my. I told my wife the next time he comes, I'm going to go see him at least nine times. So.
You guys saw him when he played the Link, man. Like, I mean, like everybody likes to play the baseball stadium. Go play the Link. Yeah, he can do the Link.
He could do the Link. I mean, he played. I don't know, three nights. Yeah. He played three nights at Citizens Bank Park last time I was here.
Yeah.
No.
I think my prediction. He'll play. So we just Philadelphia just got to host one of the cities to host the World Cup.
Yeah.
So I think right around then.
Yeah.
He'll be playing.
Yeah. And it's like, I mean, we talked about this before in the episode we did on him, but that's like, I mean, it's a home game for him.
Absolutely.
Like, it's easy. Like,
it's
that was
easy for
Spectrum
him. The
Spectrum was the first place he
New
like,
York,
big
New
theater.
Jersey, Philadelphia. Yeah.
He drives home. He even, like, one time I saw him, he was like, the New Jersey Turnpike's a son of a bitch getting down here.
Nah, he takes his plane now.
Yeah.
He says whenever he plays, like, on this coast, he goes home at night.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's the best.
Yeah. I'm excited to see it. Now that the Motley Crue show is over, that's the next one up for me that I'm really, really looking forward to. Scene. I just need some of that in my life, man.
I need shows to go to. I enjoy the whole part of going to a concert, sitting in the parking lot, tailgating, seeing the freaks, people watch. You know, a lot of it is like the Grateful Dead or whatever version of the Grateful Dead's out there now. About it's great that I can turn people on to the Dead. And that's a big summer thing.
And that was my experience. You know, like Ryan turned me on to the Dead and it was like all summer shows.
Yeah. The summertime is when it's concert season.
Yeah.
And like I'm like the Dead is playing here Sunday. I don't have tickets. So I'm just gonna grab my little cooler, take a walk down there. And if you're from Philadelphia, go hang down on 10th Street.
Nope. I'm going. All right. I got Hall of Fame tickets.
I have no doubt you do.
Yeah,
I had them last year. And I have a little stash. And it's going to be fucking awesome.
Yeah. But, dude, a miracle can happen for me. So, whoever, you never know.
Yeah, cheapos.
That's all right. I'm good.
Fucking walking around with your finger in the air.
No.
Right. Looking
I'm waiting around your friend, our friend anyway, who gave you the backstage pass. Like, Cusk, come here.
Yeah,
I got a ticket for you.
Could
happen.
It could happen.
Yeah, man. You know another great summertime song, man, is Under the Boardwalk by the Drifters.
Absolutely.
Again, with that's like almost a sure like doo-wop kind of sound. They're great, man, the Drifters.
Yeah. But do you think that's like an our coast kind of thing, or do you think that exists like on the West Coast also?
I don't know. I don't know where they're from.
No, meaning like, you know, how we're so nostalgic about
maybe
some of these
songs were bigger on coast than other coasts.
Yeah, because they always had like Beach Boys and things like that. Like that was global.
California.
Yeah, but
they were
global.
Worldly.
Yeah,
Beach Boys were worldly.
Global.
Yeah, they're from New York.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, man, I'll play a little bit of it.
Down by the sea, on a blanket with my baby's where I'll be.
Under the boardwalk.
Out of the sun.
Under the boardwalk.
Having some fun
under the boardwalk.
People walking about
under the boardwalk.
We'll be making love
under the boardwalk.
I bet people love that song and never even been on a boardwalk and have dreams to walk along a boardwalk that we take
for granted.
We totally do.
I ask people that all the time, like, you know, that are out of town, like, you know, we're so spoiled, like,
Right, like culture, we take it for a whole culture of the beach culture. Yeah. But
but that song, I will never get tired of hearing that song.
No, like you said before a couple times, man. Like a lazy Sunday, sitting out with a glass of lemonade, hammock.
Yep,
they're great, man. They're so smooth, and it's got that little like Spanish guitar kind of sound. And
then you have like the percussion. I feel like an idiot. I'm a musician. I'm not a percussionist. Like
whatever that thing is making that zip sound.
Dude, it's hypnotic, man. Like, you space out and, like, it's like four other songs play. You're still fucking thinking of it. Like,
Right. You can see it, right? Yeah. You're like, I'm under the boardwalk.
Yeah.
Just hanging out.
Yeah, you know, making out under the boardwalk.
Yeah.
You know, having some fun.
Right.
You know, good shit.
There's probably all normally, like, empty beer bottles and all kinds of other good shit underneath there.
Toxic. Right,
dude, graffiti. More than a couple of years ago, we're walking down boardwalk with my nieces, you know. And these kids are underneath the boardwalk, and they're sticking a dollar between the cracks and everything. Like, and you see everybody go and crack it, and they pull it, and you hear them all laughing. And like, I run up and I just fucking step on it, and you're like, "Pull, pull, pull!" I'm like, "Your grandfather showed you that trick."
That's funny.
We're done.
So. How can we talk about summer and the beach if we're not going to talk about the Beach Boys?
Oh my absolutely. God, right. We've been talking for 40 minutes.
Dude, I think you should just spin the wheel and just pick a song.
I have a song.
Go for it.
I have a song.
Here you go. Here it is.
I love the colorful clothes you wear and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair. I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm backing up vibrations. She's giving me the excitations.
Dude, I mean, you had them in your top six American rock and roll bands.
Yes, so. Yeah.
They are so, like, just, again, listening to it with the headphones on, there is so much going on in that song.
Brian
just
how
fucking brilliant they were, man.
It's amazing.
Brian Wilson famously, like, plicked the strums off a piano to make certain sounds out. He's driving Mike Love crazy.
Yeah.
And that bass part, they kept on doing it over and over and over and over again. And Brian Wilson thought it wasn't correct. So he did it 1,000 times. And the band was like, no, come on. Like, poor guy. He really
I don't know. Like, are they still
popular?
Like, I don't know. Are they like dismissed as kind of like, oh, yeah, okay, they wrote all
these songs. But I think it's because it's your grandfather's music at this point. But, they're like Ryan.
It's so, I mean, the harmonies and
important rock and roll.
I don't think they'll ever die. Time.
No, they won't.
I don't think they'll ever die. They'll always have something out there. Like Brian Wilson's out there right now.
Yeah.
He's out there with Al Jardine playing with him.
Mm.
And Brian Wilson, God bless him, he goes out there and he's making an appearance. I don't know how much he's playing. The poor guy had stroke like 30 years ago, you know. And he just goes out there and everybody just loves to see him.
They got Uncle Jesse still playing drums with him.
No. They got me playing drums now.
Right.
Yeah. Right. But, dude, like, that song, like, I remember sitting on the beach with Ryan last year, man, and we're indulging in things, and it's just like, man,
this great music,
this blows my doors off.
There's the part that we didn't get to, and they get to the basically harmony, doo-wop, slow part of the song, and then all of a sudden,
it comes back in.
It comes, that's fucking metal.
Let's find it, man. Here you go. I have a pause. I didn't just, like, stop it. Let's just pick it up again, and let's find it.
That is metal. When that's like beginning, like Lemmy, hearing a drive, like here go.
I wonder what they're using on that.
It's a cello.
No, I understand that, but what they're using to make that, like something's got to be vibrating on that. Like it's not a boat. It's not a boat.
It's one of those things.
There's something with the ridges, like a nail or some shit. Like, I mean, or a screw. I'm
making
sorry.
That sound.
That's making that sound.
In this movie that I watched, in this movie that I watched, they were kept on going back and back and back to that cello part mm-hmm. because Brian Wilson couldn't get it through his head that it was selling.
It didn't exist.
We should
no, he couldn't get it in his head. He couldn't get it all taped the way he had in his head
because
he kept on doing it over and over and over and over again. It drove the band nuts.
Yeah.
We should do one of our album face-offs. We should do like Pet Sounds versus like Sergeant Pepper.
That sounds awesome.
Nah, I mean, we could go like track because that was like records. That was like the
that's
well, Pet Sounds wins. Pet Sounds wins.
I think so too. But Pet Sounds. Well, I don't know. That's also my favorite Beatles album.
I thought Pet Sounds was the answer to Rubber Soul.
Was it?
You might be right.
Yeah, you might be right. I believe so. Right, well, maybe we do that then or something. Yeah. Like it'd just be
or Rubber Soul and Revolver.
Yeah.
There's something like that.
Yeah, it's like the American counter to the brilliance.
I'm pretty sure it's Rubber Soul. But what do I know?
You might be right.
Yeah.
No.
Next song, kids.
Yeah, man. What do we got? So I got a couple things on here. I got
Do you get any country stuff on there?
I do. I only put like one or two country songs on here. But I think country music is a big part of. You know what song? You guys are probably going to fucking hate on me for doing this, dunk on me for playing this.
Is it the Red Solo Cup song?
No.
Oh, thank God.
No. I heard that enough camping this past weekend, but...
People still play that?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's still, in the rotation. Toby Keith. All Summer Long by Kid Rock. I know, man.
Yikes.
It's got the...
he is America.
It's
America.
I like Kid Rock.
No.
I've seen him a bunch of times. Yeah, yeah. I don't care if he was like the white rapper for
but
a while.
But is he country? Is it like a pure country? You know?
No, I mean, this is a mashup of, what is it? It's
That's all he is a mashup.
Yeah.
That's his gimmick, yeah.
Skynyrd and Warren Zevon put together. But it's just like, man, I think of Summertime,
it's
like, man.
It's Werewolves in London and Sweet Home Alabama.
Yeah, I hate a little bit of it.
Right on. I will give Kid Rock this one thing. He is a way better singer than Anthony Kiedis will ever be.
I hear you. But, dude, that's like, this is not a compliment, but that song writes itself.
Sure.
And it's just like, I'm walking down the street and I got a pocket full of money.
I was sitting here thinking, does Kid Rock...
You wrote that shit in 5 minutes.
Well,
it was a big hit. Yeah. Go ahead.
No, I was just wondering if he writes songs like rappers do. Like, they find the beat and the gimmick. And then they write the words.
It could be.
Absolutely.
I mean, he's reinvented himself. Like, you know, he's country now. And some
is
of his
he
stuff,
real country?
His stuff's pretty yee-haw.
Well, he has a bar in Nashville.
Yeah.
He's a hick from Detroit.
Yeah. I think he grew up kind of wealthy. I don't think he's not a good old
boy.
He's
like 8 Mile. 8 Mile. He didn't live on 8 Mile or Lincoln Park.
Yeah, he's not as much as he says he is. And I like this part of his career. We're probably going to go see him this summer. He's on the road.
Where's he at?
Is it the $20 show?
I think he's playing... I'm not sure if it's the $20 show. I think he's playing Camden or the...
It's the $25 show now.
Yeah, probably. But he's done shit, too, where like...
I haven't seen him. I'd love to see him.
I saw him with like Cool in the Gang.
It was
you know, and he's got all the fireworks and shit, and he still had Joe C when he was still alive.
See, that's the show I want to see. When I saw him down, me and Ann went to go see him down here at the Wells Fargo Center. I was not like accepted by the crowd. I walk here. This is where I live. You guys got to drive like 3 hours. You're a bunch of yahas, you know? So I did I would like to see a rock and roll show rather than a country show.
Like a Lynyrd Skynyrd version of Kid Rock.
Yeah. That's kind
of up there on the podium. Did the kind of Donald Trump thing, you know? That's his crowd.
But you know what? He's a cool dude. He goes out to karaoke shit when he does, and he's always good to his fans.
Yeah.
You know, I dig him.
Yeah.
You know, his music isn't that fucking good, but I dig how he fucking treats his fans.
Yeah, I like it. I like his stuff. You know, and it's more kind of like Skynyrd, Bon Jovi version of like Lynyrd Skynyrd than like country music. But
he knows his audience.
Yeah,
he knows his audience.
I think country music is Bon Jovi music. Like I call it country, Bon Jovi country.
You said that when we did the bar list, and I had Luke Combs on there, and I keep calling it that. And I think I'm getting more and more redneck as I'm getting older because I've gone.
I think we are a little bit.
I've gone further up, like in the country stations on SiriusXM. I've gone further up to like outlaw country, which is like
that's the real shit, like Johnny Cash and
Like Waylon Jennings and all that, like Hank Williams and some real like a lot of fiddle and
fiddle.
I remember when country music started getting really big on the beach. And Ryan, what did you say?
I was like, when did a cowboy start going to the beach?
Right.
It's like, it's
what
true.
What the fuck's going on here?
Yeah, some of those guys.
But now they have concerts on the beach. There's country shows.
That huge Wildwood. Country show in Wildwood, man. It was like Carrie Underwood and all those other artists. So, I mean, I could play a ton of that stuff. I said we were just camping for the weekend over a long 4th of July, and it was like the country music was playing the whole time out of the camper.
Like, you know, why I brought up it, like country music is a big...
It's the biggest music in the world.
It is, but it's a big summertime sound now. It's a big all-time sound. But summertime, you start... It resurfaces, comes out of the dirt, and the girls in the cowboy boots come out in the dirt.
I hear their fucking trash shows, man.
Oh, absolutely.
Like, it's a shit show. It's like a tractor trailer show.
Yeah.
Like all the rednecks show up and the girls in the bikinis. And I talk to these guys in South Philadelphia and they got fucking cowboys hats on.
Yeah.
I'm like, why do you have a legit cowboy hat on? Oh, because I'm seeing this show. Well, why are you going to show? Oh, because that's where the girls are.
Of course,
I'm like,
yeah.
Jesus Christ, do you even care about the music?
Yeah. I mean, like, I'll play a kind of a country song. Like, Darius Rucker from Hootie.
Hootie.
The Blowfish has got, like, a whole second career. That song, Wagon Wheel, was enormous.
Yeah, it was a big song.
But he has a song like Beers and Sunshine that is just, like, it just makes me think, you know, he's singing about... I'm sitting by the dock in my house in South Carolina, and I'm just hitting golf balls off of it and getting drunk. And it's just like, here's a little bit.
Because he can. He still got the Hootie money.
Well, I ain't gonna work today. Just wanna sit around and play. Gonna hit balls off the dock. Kick back in my flip-flops. Don't owe nothing to the lender. Nothing spinning in the blender. The only thing on my agenda is beers and sunshine, bonfires in summertime, back porch nights in South Carolina. Ain't nothing finer than me and my girls driving up a little
line. Yeah, I dig it.
You know, it just... It's good, happy.
Dumped those losers in the Hootie, and he just went out in his zone and has these hits.
Yeah.
It's like you said, man. You like happy music. Like a lot of country music is just, you know. There's always like the girl left and my dog died and my truck broke down. But there's just a lot of other end of it.
Dude, it's a simple song and that's great. Like it's simple words.
Right.
It's just like he's probably like just it's very obvious.
Right.
Like
right.
I mean, everybody knows where it's like you paint the picture
in
your head.
Surgery.
No.
He said the lyrics themselves. Right.
The lyrics write themselves, and he's painting a picture in your head.
Sure, yeah,
you know what I mean? And that takes genius by itself. Like simpler is better, as you know, we all say in the music life, you know, in the music world, musician wise, less is better.
Yeah, he's definitely not like Leonard Cohen with his lyrics,
but it's his voice like, is the main thing.
Yeah.
He'd make more money doing
that. Yeah, and that's like, and that's a lot of.
He was always
music,
a great singer. He didn't even need the Blowfish back in the day.
No,
I mean, it's great to see him make a comeback.
Yeah. Yeah,
dude, up until a few years ago, maybe 5 years ago, I'm like, this guy's a big deal. Everybody's like, yeah, man. I'm like,
he was like
no
huge.
Shit, motherfucker.
Yeah. Right, right. Yeah. You learned something.
Basically.
What else we got on here, man? Oh, we got to play some Bob Marley, dude.
Yeah.
I know, Doug, you're a big Bob Marley fan. Yeah. You got a song you want to hear?
Three Little Birds.
There you go. That's actually the one
I
put on here.
Wow, I should be on a game show. It's a game show.
Look at that.
You know me so well.
Is there anything more perfect
Have you guys ever been to Jamaica?
Yeah.
Yeah. No. And that is their whole gimmick down there. It's like, there's no problem. Like, no problem, man. You know why? Because there's no problem when you're there.
Yeah.
Right.
Like, they will totally take care of you there. It's unbelievable.
Except when they were trying to kill Bob Marley.
Yeah. Right? That,
no, I don't, yo, their politic shit, they can go fuck themselves with that shit.
Right.
But like, go sit on a resort for a week. Dude. So fucking beautiful, and that song is way on the limit with that, man.
When that's an all-time song for me. Like, that song's good for me anytime. I have this thing about myself. If I get so stressed out when I can't handle anything, I let it take over for five. Like, there's some movie years ago, like, I'll let the fear take over for 5 minutes, and then I gotta go forward. Like, if I'm so stressed out, I'll think of that song, or I'll play it like in my headphones,
just does something for you.
And I'm just like, okay, I'm ready to go.
His whole catalog awesome. Is relaxing.
Yeah, sure.
You know, I mean, he did a lot of political stuff, which got him jammed up.
Yeah.
You know? And what caught up with him and killed him was cancer.
Yeah.
Yeah. We talked a little bit.
We did a whole show on him.
Yeah. Because of his religion.
Rastafarian.
Yeah. It's really, really cool.
The Rastafarian.
But yeah, Bob Marley's a good time anytime, no matter where you are.
Yeah.
If you're in Alaska, if you're in China, if you're in Jamaica, if you're in South Philadelphia.
Huge in China.
I'm
being serious. As much as cannabis is getting bigger and bigger and bigger in the world, I'm sure he has a following in Asia somewhere.
I'm sure he does.
Yeah. With the internet, this thing called the internet,
right?
Like, I'm sure,
and all the people listen over there to us. So yeah.
He has a quote. It says, "When the music hits you, you feel no pain."
Yep. Exactly.
Yep. Do you guys listen to, you guys like country music? You guys know Eric Church?
Yes.
I know the name. I'm sure if you played a song, I would know it.
Big Yeehaw. He has a song called Springsteen. It's about Springsteen.
Yeah.
Let's hear a little bit of it.
Yeah.
I love this song. But
took the long way to your house. I can still hear the sound of you saying don't go. When I think about you, I think about 17. I think about my OG. I think about in the sky. Funny how a melody sounds like a memory, like a soundtrack to a July Saturday night. Springsteen.
Same thing, just paint the picture, man.
I liked it. Like, I like how he talked about his dad. And we're getting at that, like, one thing that our father always says, like, music is a time capsule. It brings you back where you were. It's a time traveling thing.
That line in that song, like, funny how music sounds like a memory. It's like, I hear certain songs, it's absolutely true.
The style of that song is very Springsteenish.
Yeah. It is.
Has the piano dancing on top of a back. Around.
Does Springsteen ever like comment on any of that?
I don't think so.
Because it's stupid.
It is. And it's another song that writes itself.
A lot of the country stuff does.
No, that's cool. I wish I was talented enough to like write simple songs, you know?
I like his dedication to Springsteen.
Yeah.
Right on, dude.
Yeah. We're talking about an hour. You want to take a break?
Yeah, sure.
All right, man. All right, so we'll take a break. We'll come back. I got some more songs, and if some other stuff that kind of pops into our minds, we're going to play that, and then I guess we'll take it from there.
Awesome.
Stick around.
Prisoners of Rock and Roll is sponsored by McCusker's Tavern at 17th and Shunk Streets in Philadelphia. There's something for everyone on the beer list and the jukebox at McCusker's. It's minutes from the sports stadiums in Philly, making it a great place to stop by for a few drinks before or after a concert or a game. Come see for yourself why everyone from Philadelphia Magazine to Playboy has called it one of the best dive bars in the city. Visit them at 17th and Shunk Streets in Philadelphia or on Facebook. That's McCusker's Tavern. Hey, Ryan.
Hey, now.
We're so happy that Prisoners of Rock and Roll is sponsored by our friends over at Boldfoot Socks. And the last time we made a joke about the Warden's tattoo about, you know, good ones ain't cheap and cheap ones ain't good. But when you have a good one, when you have something good, it makes you look good. It makes you feel good.
If you want something good, you have to spend good money to get something good.
Yeah, man. And that's like Boldfoot socks, because, I mean, they're comfortable and they look good. You know, and I've said before, like, you know, I like musicians that are good people. And I feel that way about like companies I do business with, because, you know, Boldfoot socks are made in America. They're veteran owned. They give money back to veteran charities.
That's amazing.
And that's also, you know, the Warden took that to heart in the last episode, and he got his tattoo cleaned up.
I did. Yeah, man. It was, remember that I had the great idea on our show, And I don't know if people at home remember that, but the warden has a really, or he did.
He had
a really bad arm tattoo.
Of a song that we threw in the electric chair because it was on his tattooed on his arm.
But we just got it covered up with a brand new awesome tattoo of a tractor trailer and a truck.
Yeah.
With the Phillies
logo. I'll have to share it on our social media
page. And it has the Phillies logo on the front. That was also my idea.
Yes.
I take all the credit for that tattoo.
And you had the idea like on the show because we were laughing hysterically at it. Yes. And that's what he should have done.
I thought about how long the tattoo was. And I was like, oh, well, you're a truck driver, Rob. You know, why don't you get a cab? He is an awesome truck driver, and he is also our lovable warden.
Yes.
He's at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame right now.
Yeah. 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 He's like our man. Like Doug, you said, he's our man on the street. Man on the street. So.
Look what we did to him in the last 24 hours. We rock and rolled him. We got him a new tattoo, and he's on his way to the Rock and Roll Hall.
I'm really proud of him.
His tattoo looks great, man.
Yeah, it looks great.
Hey, man, I take all the credit for that shit.
But I'm really proud of him for going to Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I like to think that we have a little piece to do, a little something to do with that.
I think so.
Because he knows nothing without us, damn it.
But I text, like, through the great world of Facebook, I got in touch with him. I'm like, oh, what's the exhibit? Like, the Beatles. I'm like, are you serious?
It's probably really cool. It's really cool. He sent me a picture of Clarence Clemons' guitar, or Clarence Clemons' saxophone. He texted me when I was driving down here.
For Rob anyway, you know, getting his tattoo covered up, it's kind of changing his life a little bit.
Man.
Yeah, I think it's going to help him with the ladies.
Yeah.
We shall see. So
we'll see.
That was a selling thing to him. I said, hey, this will help you with the ladies, my friend. Chicks dig tattoos.
Good tattoos.
Now he has a banging tattoo.
He's got a good one.
Did Fred do it?
Fred did do it.
Nice. Awesome.
Yeah. I set him up with the best tattoo artist around, or I think anyway. But yeah, right on.
Good stuff, man.
Good for the warden.
Yeah. Good
but
for
the
him.
Socks, yes.
Oh, yeah, Boldfoot socks, man. It's boldfoot.com. They're comfy as hell, man. I said I had to go in the office a couple times for work, and I wore them. So the one day I actually have to, like, dress somewhat respectably. I'm wearing my Motley Crue poisoned Def Leppard shirt right now that I wore as I was sitting working from home all day today. But, you know, it's all good. So,
did you notice my shirt?
Who is that on your shirt? Is that Iggy Pop?
No, it's so we, okay, make a long story short. So during our break, we lost, in my opinion, one of my biggest influence bass players of all time, Alex John Such from Bon Jovi.
Okay.
And a major influence in my life. So he passed away. I took it, like, you know, it's like, you know, it's like kind of like,
yeah, sure,
you know,
sure.
Childhood heroes.
Yeah.
So, you know, got the shirt.
Oh, rocking cool. it. Right know. On, man. Cool.
So anyway.
No.
I thought it was the fucking singer from that punk rock band.
No, Alex is just that cool, man.
That's Alex.
Yeah.
He's right just, on. But he looks like Ving, whatever.
Leaving.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He looks like Leaving in that picture.
I love Living in the City.
Yeah, guy. That's who yeah. I thought it was when you walked. Yeah. I didn't even know it was Alex John Such.
Yeah.
Wow. He
I
looks
also
just
have
like
a Leaving
him.
Shirt that I wear.
Yeah,
all
that's,
the time.
What, I th- that's yeah. what I thought it was.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I still listen to that song once in a while. I'd never heard it before doing this show.
They got a lot of great songs, yeah, dude. They got.
Oh, yeah.
Living in the City. That's my song.
The one. I like that song.
I love Living in the City. Yeah.
All right, man. Diving back. Oh, shit. You know what we haven't talked about yet, man? It's like the sound of summer is Jimmy Buffett.
Yes.
You know, like, and Jimmy Buffett is, I mentioned some other country artists, like Jason Aldean is like that, and the Zac Brown Band. Like, there's bands that just sell that.
Yeah, I like the Zac
Brown
Band.
Sure kind of sound. Zac Brown Band is kind of like if you made one of those, like, Venn diagram things, it'd be like where Buffett and like Dave Matthews Band come together.
Yeah.
They're okay.
If there was a country show, like that's the one I would pick to go to.
Yeah.
Buffett?
Yeah. No, I know you don't like Zac Brown Band.
The Zac Brown Band.
Yeah. I went years ago and you were busting my balls on Facebook.
They're fucking great. They're a good time, dude.
I guess so.
They're a good time.
Yeah,
it's just
a party, man. And
Buffett, a redneck party.
Yeah.
But Buffett, though, like
Buffett. I've seen him.
Yeah.
I've seen him. I say I saw him, and tell you the truth, guys, I'll never go see him again.
I've never seen so many friggin' people at that place in Camden.
Yeah.
That, like, we walked in late.
That were wasted.
Like, from the stage to the back wall and the lawn.
They're an interesting crowd. I'll just say that enough.
They're the worst. I'll say that. They are some of the Parrot Heads are the worst fans in rock and roll. They really are. Because
it's all trust fund.
No, they're all older now. They all think they have seniority over everything, over shit, you know. So what? So you follow Jimmy Buffett. Who gives a fuck? He's a multimillionaire. you know,
self-made.
And you guys will buy anything he fucking does.
He sells like retirement communities now. Yeah, you can go live. I have a big ass,
right, man.
I have a huge. He's not Margaritaville, even that, guys, margarita machine.
I
in my
swear
house.
To God, he's not even that talented. He's not.
He
even
can't
that
good. Say. He can't.
He can't fucking write a song. You know what the fuck is cheeseburger? Cheeseburger with Paradise.
I'm not necessarily. I'm not disagreeing with you at all.
What is that,
dude? He's a household name.
Because he has Margaritaville.
Exactly.
Down on Atlantic City. On the boardwalk in Atlantic City.
Been there, man.
You know what he's brilliant at? Marketing.
Yes. Merchandising.
He wrote a book about merchandising.
Yeah, because he sells that lifestyle. Like, people go to those shows because those are the people that have, like, sand dumped in the parking lot.
Yeah. But he wrote novels also. Yeah. Like, you know what I mean? And, dude, I want to be a pirate too, man. Like, it influences people's lives, just like the Dead and, like, whatever, you know?
He's just like a beach bum singer-songwriter dude.
It's not so horrible life, man.
Yeah.
Why not dream the dream, you know?
No, those guys, the Parrotheads, they take the vacation with them wherever they go, their music.
Awesome.
Yeah, and you can get everything from, like, sauce to,
he's like Kiss. Right. He's got everything.
Right. He's the Key West version. He's a palm tree version of Kiss. He'll sell you
Kiss
anything.
Kiss doesn't have a restaurant yet, though.
I'm amazed by that. Yeah.
Gene, are you listening? We want a restaurant.
You know what's like? It's crazy, too, man.
Can you imagine?
The country station on Sirius has, like, they broadcast, like, a happy hour from, like, Nashville every Friday, and it's always from Margaritaville. And I'm like, man, there are so many cool places on that street.
Yeah, like the Kid Rock Bar.
Right. One you're going to go to is, like, the chain restaurant.
Yeah. But, they get the most money. They gave them the most money.
Right.
Yeah. And sure, their margaritas are something.
They are. I've been them.
They're banging.
They are. But, dude, I give the guy all the credit in the world. He's self-made.
Yeah.
He has ideas.
Let's hear a song.
I put Mexico on here. It's
an obscure song.
Yeah, it's a little newer, but I like it. No,
way down here, you need a reason to move. Feel a boo, run at your stateside game. Lose your load, leave your mind behind. Baby James, oh, Mexico. It sounds so simple, I just got to go.
I think all the country bands rip him off.
Of course they do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, Zac Brown Band. Absolutely.
Well, during the song, we were talking about Buffett and this and that. So we were on the beach one day, and my niece was young, and she's getting into country music, and she's listening to Zac Brown Band. I'm like, dude, this sounds like a Jimmy Buffett. She's like, oh, I know who that is. She don't know who shit is. And it was like, Jimmy Buffett was singing on the song. It's like, oh, that guy sings on the song with him. Who is he? It's Jimmy Buffett, bro.
Buffett's done some stuff with them. I think there's a line in one of their songs, like, what would Jimmy Buffett do?
And
great. Sounds
dude,
fabulous.
Like, just like the Dead and just like Fish and whatever, these jam bands or whatever, he has a culture, dude. And he has a community. And that's amazing when somebody can create that out of his music.
Out of shitty music.
I work with a guy that's
peaches,
like,
apples and oranges, man. Some people... No, it's all where you're at.
What the hell
do
I know? I got a podcast.
Right.
I hear you.
I work with a guy who's like with them, like the way you are with Fish. Like, he goes every year. Like front row seats.
It's a good time. You got to look forward to something.
Yeah. And he's a dude that wasn't like, oh my God, I had so much. I'm so, but it was like kind of like, okay, cool. I'm glad I went and I saw it. I wore a Hawaiian shirt and a stupid hat.
You got to
just enjoyed the whole experience.
Enjoy yourself.
Yeah. Yeah, so we saw him again. I've seen him twice. The second time, I was kind of like, all right, I don't need to do this.
I'm
again.
Over this.
Yeah, it was one of those like $20 tickets on like Groupon
crazy
or something.
To go.
We're like, let's grab him and go. But I don't need
free
to
parking.
Go, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, free parking.
Yeah. So, all right. All day long.
Yeah, man.
Go make fun of people, dude.
Yeah. What else we got? Oh, dude, a song that we haven't played yet is "In the Summertime" by Mungo Jerry.
I don't know that one.
You know it if I play it.
Play
it.
Summertime.
I don't mind this song.
These dudes, you have to watch the video of this. These are the strangest looking guys.
What year is this from?
Hang on.
Is it from the 60s?
69, 68, 72, probably 68 to 70.
Okay, so it's right in there.
Yeah.
I do enjoy this song.
It's ragtime-ish.
Yeah. I'm surprised nobody ever covered this and tried to make...
I'll tell you why.
Watch the video for that, because whatever you think these guys look like, It is not. I'll turn the laptop around.
I think they look like a bunch of rednecks.
Hang on. You can kind of see his face.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. He's like, he has a side curl
chops.
Yeah.
He has like a Bobby Brady haircut.
Yeah,
whatever.
It's really
but
weird.
Dude, but dude, it's the times.
Yeah, it's just
everybody had a perm.
Yeah, everybody
had a perm. Just a feel good kind of summertime. You know,
dude, I like it. I always like that song. I think it's great. It's a, you know, it sets a mood.
That was a song like I remember the beat as a little kid.
Yeah.
Before I even like knew who sang it or what it was. I'm like, oh, I know that. Like do cha.
That's cool. You know what the one thing in the summer in the city? Some days it was just way too hot to go outside. So of course we just sat around and watched MTV.
Of course.
On MTV. And the one video that makes me think of the beach is Huey Lewis in the News.
I was going to ask you when the news was going to happen.
Yeah, the news is my shit on the beach.
Yeah, we always do. People, we just see the news.
Dude, I love the news.
Yeah.
Like, if this was it, that video, them on the beach, and then remember they're all in the sand, and their heads were sticking out of the sand, and they're doing going back and forth.
Yeah.
Play some.
Yeah, here you go.
I think
we've made it 43 episodes without talking about him.
Dude, the news is just like...
He was huge, dude, man. He had so many...
huge. He's going to put him in the Rock and Roll thing.
He's one of those guys, you're like, I know that song.
Yeah,
shit, I know that song.
You go see him, it's going to be hit, super hit.
Yeah.
Dude, it's like the sound of Back to the Future is Huey Lewis.
Yeah.
You know?
But he's just like an amazing guy. It's like his story. Yeah. He's like, he grew up wealthy.
He's a trust fund baby.
Yeah, he grew up wealthy. But I think his dad was like self-made. Like he made his money, but he grew up wealthy. So make a long story short, he graduated from high school. And he's like, you're not going directly to college. I'm giving you this money. You're going to go abroad and you're going to travel. You're going to run out of money and then you're on your own. So he winds up in India and he's seeing like snake charmers and things like that.
Yeah.
And he's got a harmonica. And he's like, well, I got to make money somehow. He starts playing the harmonica, he starts making money. He's like, this is a good way of living.
This is like college. 18 years old.
Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't know anything about him. He's an amazing, it's an amazing story.
Like, he's a big sports fan.
That was the name of the album.
Yeah. Sports, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I said, like, during the quarantine, like, we were really, like, really getting in the news. Like, we're sitting in my backyard and hanging out. And I'm like, Rye, we should start a Huey Lewis in the News cover band. And call it like an American Psycho, whatever Jared Leto's name is, and the Dorsey is, and just call him, and just call the News like cover band that.
All right, Huey Lewis is good, but his backup band is the shit.
Yeah,
the News is the shit. Yeah. Their bass player,
yeah, he's the man.
Whatever his name is,
yeah.
He was always the man with the black shades on and the little flavor saver thing.
He was the gimmick. He was the bass player.
Like, he was the bass player. He had the cigarette in his mouth all the time.
Yeah.
That was cool shit, man.
Their
videos were always awesome.
Like another song,
they made MTV.
Yeah, another song if you want to play that I love by them is called "Doing It All for My Baby."
Okay,
and that's a great song. And that was a big video. It was like kind of like a not a beach video, but it was like a Universal Monster kind of video. But I just love the tune.
Doing It All for My Baby, yeah, man. Here.
Very Springsteen-ish.
Early in the morning,
in my sleepy head.
19 top 10 hits.
Why isn't he a Rock and Roll fan?
That's a good point, man.
Dude, he was in a movie with fucking that won an Oscar.
But that movie wasn't very good.
But it won an Oscar.
He almost banged his daughter in the movie. That's what the movie was about. It was called Duets.
Yeah.
And she's a singer, and she goes out duets and starts doing meeting people, and she meets Huey Lewis's character, and they almost hook up, and it's like, find out that's her father.
Oh, really? I've never seen it.
Yeah.
But, like,
What did you say during the song? The 19 number one hits?
Yeah, 19 top 10 hits.
Or 19 top 10
Dude,
hits.
Dude, why are they not in the Rock and Roll Hall?
I don't know. I've said that for
like,
a long time.
Are they too like too much fun? Oh, no. They can't put Huey Lewis in
serious.
There. Just like how Poison can't be taken seriously, how Motley Crue can't be seriously. Huey Lewis can't be considered seriously? Come on.
But, dude, it's like it's a sound of the 80s. Like you're saying, like it's back it's in the future. It's this. Yeah. It's a sound of the 80s. No other band.
Gonna go back in time.
I need a new drug. Like that was a popular song. I need a new drug.
It was so good.
Basically talking about doing drugs.
It was so good. Ray Parker Jr. ripped it off and made Ghostbusters hear it.
Yeah,
that's how fucking good it was.
I don't think he's ever been nominated either. That's a good point, man. Because yeah. I mean, that's you think about those bands in the '80s. Like they just turned out all those hits.
Yeah, but they were the sound of the '80s, man. They were everywhere. They're Coca-Cola commercials,
everywhere.
Man.
They were everywhere.
Yeah.
They were super huge.
But it was like that big 80s thing, like going back to American Psycho. Like, you know what I mean? That corporate, like everybody's going to let loose. Like, sports is an amazing album.
But they weren't a new wave band.
No, they weren't.
They weren't they're like a rock band. And roll band.
Yeah, they're like bar music.
They're a bar
yeah.
band.
Yeah.
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 Like I said, they're very Springsteen. Like, there was that organ sound, very Springsteen-ish.
Yeah. Cool. What else we got on here, man? Oh, you had Tears for Fears on here.
Dude, this song makes me think of the Ocean Breeze.
I wanted to go see them. They were in town like 2 weeks
they
ago.
They were. And they had garbage open up for
yeah,
them.
Yeah, and I didn't go, man. I used to listen to their Greatest Hits album when I was like in high school so much.
There's this town,
this
man.
Song, yeah. This song is just freaking awesome.
Yeah, their new album is really good, too.
I'm sure it is. Yeah, it's really good. They're talented guys.
Yeah, here you go. I dig it, man.
Yeah.
I like a lot of this 80s stuff.
That's me sitting on the beach, dude.
Dude, a few years ago, I looked up Shout, and I found a live version. It's from like VH1 concert or whatever. Their band was so huge. They had a guy playing the bottles. Like, if you think of the song Shout.
Tears for Fears. Oh, okay. Yeah. That would have. Oh, yeah.
Dude, it was amazing. Like, I just watched it like a year ago, 2 years ago.
And that
I was like,
song is and a these, monster.
And like, you know, it's a long time. It was, I guess it was in the 90s. But these and that song, like those songs came out a long time ago in the 80s. And it was just like, man, these guys are talented. The band is talented. Just everything. They sound just like the record. You know what I mean? Like, usually we see a band live, they sound a little bit different. Sometimes I prefer it.
Yeah.
But to see a band like that and they play it like they sound like the record, that's amazing.
It makes me feel like, again, they take the studio and make it. An instrument.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're master. You can hear it. It's flawless.
Yeah.
The guitar, clean guitar sound. I just see the ocean coming up, you know, up the sand.
Yeah, sure. Really cool.
What else you got in there?
I don't know. That's one of my always go to beach songs.
That's a good one. Just hanging out. Drift Away by Dobie Gray. I love this song.
Oh, this is a great song.
Yeah. Play it. Yeah.
So that's a game that I hate to lose, and I'm feeling the strain. Ain't it a shame? Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away. Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll.
That great song.
Love it.
Dude.
I love that. That's
again, just hanging out. Just,
yeah. When we were kids, we had this Bon Jovi bootleg on cassette, and they broke down into that fucking song, and it was genius. And my 12-year-old self was like, holy shit.
Yeah, they killed it.
They just broke in the fucking, you know.
But the vocal part, they just fucking crushed it, man.
They were all young. Like three-part harmony.
Cool. Yeah. That, it might have been four-part harmony. Dude, it was like unbelievable.
Very cool. Yeah. But who was the original song by?
That song?
Yeah.
I think it's his.
No, no, that's what I mean. What's his name?
Oh, Dobie Gray.
Dobie Gray.
I'm
yeah,
sorry.
Yeah, yeah. Right on.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. I don't think he ever did anything else. Yeah. Yeah. And a couple other artists have covered that, but it's like
hopefully made some royalties.
Yeah, sure. Oh, man, what else we got on here? We don't
have
much.
How about some Janis Joplin?
Yeah, dude. You had Summertime by Janis, Big Brother and the Holding Company.
Yes.
Man, this is
monster
like,
song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, what a great song. Awesome, awesome song.
Nice.
You know, when we... Now, you said they wrote that song, right?
Yeah, that's our song.
This isn't come from like a jazz song or anything like that, because you know, when we were kids, we saw Maynard Ferguson a few times. And even we even played it in the high school marching band. We did play Summertime. So she wrote that song. So every time we heard like Maynard Ferguson do this or whatever... So that's basically him covering Janis Joplin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maynard was always doing covers. Remember?
Yeah.
He was doing the Rocky theme song. He was doing Let It Be.
He played the Rocky theme song.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't know if he originally played the Rocky theme song. I don't know who originally did it. I don't know.
Okay. I have no idea. Okay.
But, you know, Maynard Ferguson... Where are we going with this?
No, I'm just asking because like,
Summertime.
Yeah, Summertime.
I think Janis Joplin's voice sounds like a trumpet right there.
Yeah. But you're absolutely right. Yeah. But I was just always wondering that. Until you said, I'm like, oh, did she write this song? You're like, yeah. I'm like, man, I heard the song like an instrumental 1,000 times. You know?
Yeah.
That's a song I listen to. Like, I want to close my eyes when I'm listening to it and just listen to her voice. Like, she was just amazing.
We did that special at Monterey Pop Festival.
Yeah.
And we did a little piece on her. And, you know, holy shit.
Like, yeah, dude. It's all like the amazing video of that, man, when Mama Cass is in the audience and her jaw is just open. Mm,
yeah.
And she goes, like,
she's
my God.
There. And Janis was like nobody.
Yeah.
Like, you know, she got up there and she was the highlight with Jimi Hendrix. She was the highlight of the pop.
Yeah, she blew the doors off everybody. Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Otis Redding had a great fucking set too.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good episode we did too. A lot of good music. So I think I only got one other song on here, and that was Sleepwalk by Santo and Johnny.
Very nice.
Yeah, so it's just kind of a cool.
I heard this on the radio the other day.
Yeah, man.
Just kind of like
Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, I was like sitting on the beach at night or something.
Drinking. Yeah,
yeah.
I always get lost in this song.
Yeah, I do too.
Again, if you're stressed out,
yeah, it's very chill.
I heard this on the Tom Petty "Buried Treasure."
Really?
Yeah. Today?
Oh, very cool. I don't know where I've ever heard that. Like,
it was in movies.
This is La Bamba. This is a big part of La Bamba.
Yeah. That's right.
That's the first time I ever heard the song was in La Bamba.
Yeah, like, I don't think I've ever heard it on the radio, but I knew it.
My band played this for fucking years.
Really?
It was always a highlight.
Really cool. Yeah, man, just a really cool song. I think it's the only instrumental we got on the list. So.
That's a great song. I mean, it
does. You don't have any Dick Dale on there?
I didn't, only because we've talked about him so many other times.
Right. Let's just play some Dick Dale, because.
We can put some Dick Dale on here. Hang on, let's...
You gotta pay. We're talking about the beach, man. You gotta put the king in there.
Miser Lou, we always play that, sure. We came out of this, we're just talking about like surf music in general, and then the movie Back to the Beach.
I was like, should we talk about the movie Back to the Beach? Because I feel like we're coming to an end here, but we have to mention Back to the Beach. You've never seen it, you're missing out in life.
There is a great duet in Back to the Beach, and it has Dick Dale playing with Stevie Ray Vaughan.
They're doing Pipeline.
It's fucking unreal.
Let's see if it's on here. It is. Here you go. I got it. Here's a little bit of it.
I
That movie is so, like, gloriously terrible.
But, dude, it's Annette Funicello, Frankie Avalon,
yes.
Yeah.
And Pee-wee Herman.
And there's, like, Pee-wee's second. Yeah, a lot of people just went to go see that movie.
I love Pee-wee Herman that movie. Was in it. I hope Billy can get that movie downloaded.
I think I asked him my drunkenness, like, last week.
I'm going to text him tonight.
The Humunga Cowabunga from down Under.
Yeah.
Dude, that's my next band.
Yes, the Humunga Cowabunga from Down Under.
Fuck yeah.
That'll be our, when we play Down the Shore, we get good enough to play Down the Shore.
That's what it'll be our alias.
1987.
Fucking right.
I love that movie.
I got to see that.
I did too. I haven't seen it in years, but I'll have to watch it.
I don't have no expectations of the thing holding up to like the greatness that I
think. Yeah, you might be disappointed.
No. I'm so
proud of us that we're talking about this movie now. It missed its Oscar debut. It should have won MTV Music Award or Movies Award.
Dude, I'm going to be so greased up when I watch this. I'm going to love every second of it.
That's funny, man. I think that's it summer, for the baby. Beach songs.
I
think
hope everybody is entertained as much as we were tonight.
Yeah, man. All right, I got two music news bits. First one was the Taylor Hawkins tribute shows. So the Foo Fighters are holding a pair of tribute shows to honor Taylor Hawkins. The first one will be in Wembley on the 3rd of September, and the second one will be September 27th at the Kia Forum in L.A. Man, the list – I went through the list of the people that are going to be playing at these two shows. Man, it is like
– it is, and I called – before the lineup, I'm like, Alanis Morissette's playing the California one, and she's on the show.
Is she? Yeah.
So I would imagine.
John Paul Jones, Nile Rodgers from Chic, Chris Novoselic, Leanne Rimes, Nancy Wilson, Liam Gallagher, Stuart Copeland, Mark Ronson, Wolfgang Van Halen, Geddy Lee, and Alex Lifeson from Rush, Brian May, Nikki Sixx, Chad Smith, Roger Taylor, Alanis Morissette. They're just going to pull out all the stops.
When we went and saw Motley Crue, Tommy's front head drum was Taylor Hawkins.
It was
Taylor Hawkins.
Within the last like 4 months of Taylor's life, man, he had Tommy Lee's face on his drum. It was kind of like, you know.
Maybe homage.
Homage to each other. That's fucking cool.
Here comes a big conversation. Now, what is Wolfgang Van Halen going to do?
I think Wolfgang should just worry. I don't think Wolfgang is just going to do Wolfgang. Anything is too much pressure to him.
No.
I know he's a drummer. I know he could take like that, but
apparently he's very good.
Okay, he is good, but he
is he going to play?
He'll be making himself living off that Van Halen.
All I'm asking, what is he going to do at the show? Is he going to play drums at the show, or is he going to play bass, or is he going to do?
I think he's going to do. Play whatever drums. They ever let him do. I think they're going to let him play guitar and sing choruses because I don't think he's a main part of the show.
But apparently he's a very good drummer, so I'm very intrigued to see what this guy is going to do.
Yeah, there's way better people on that show than him. I'm not even thinking about him.
But it's just like,
I'd rather see the guy from Chic than him.
Nile Rodgers.
Nile Rodgers is shit.
You got to see him not too long ago.
My work, we hired him for something, and all the proceeds are going to charity. So pretty cool. So
awesome. The Meanie's going to that one in London.
Blumini's going. I know I've been seeing him. How fired up he is about it.
Yeah,
I hope it's a good show for it. Go all the way there for it.
Yeah,
I hope it's as good as the Freddie Mercury concert.
Yeah, I think that's what they're trying to aim for, dude.
Yeah, I think so too.
Yeah.
The other show I had was the speaking of the Motley Crue Poison Def Leppard show was the Tommy Lee's Broken Ribs. So the very anticipated stadium tour got off the ground but didn't even get through one show without some craziness. You know, Tommy Lee broke 4 ribs sometimes before this tour. His doctor said, you know, don't play, and he tried pushing through it. The first night he made it through 5 songs and then he bailed out and he was replaced by Black Sabbath drummer Tommy Clufetos.
He is unbelievable. Yeah,
he was good, man.
Yeah. He backed him up maybe about 5 songs, and I was right up front, and I was glued to that dude watching him play.
So
he's so good.
I saw him with Ozzy.
I saw him with Black Sabbath, and I seen him with Ozzy.
Yeah. I was wondering, too.
Yeah, we saw him with Ozzy.
Yeah, he's great.
I was wondering if that show, like, did they agree beforehand what they were going to do, or is Tommy Lee like, hey, man, I'll go as far as I can, and he's like, oh, I can't. Like, because Tommy Lee's
out there now. Now he's playing the show, he's doing it all by himself.
But when we saw them, it was like three times he kept, so I was like, was this guy from Sabbath, was he sitting there the entire time waiting for Tommy Lee to go like, hey man, I need a break.
He
had to be that on.
He probably had select songs
Tommy was like, I don't want to play this song. I don't want to play this song.
Predetermined, or he's just they're like, definitely. Oh, dude, my, oh, yeah. They're killing me.
Two songs. Yeah. Like, I think he played, like, from the videos that I seen, he played, like, the first two songs, and then
this
guy.
Five songs.
This dude just comes out. You don't even know Tommy Lee's out. Yeah.
Right.
The stage.
No announcement other than
your people. Oh, really? Did you do an announcement?
I think show. Nobody got a shout out from Molly. Nobody
came out. Not meaning, like, he's like, did he give this speech? Because everything I seen, bro, you're never going to believe this.
He did. Yeah. He stepped away. He played, like,
he's stepping away from the drums.
Yeah, but when it was swapping out, though, he wasn't like, I'm taking a break, stuff like that. Just, so it
disappeared.
Really cool.
He just disappeared, and this guy came out, and then he came back out. It was very like David Copperfield.
But he said that this was going to happen tonight at the show.
Tonight, the show, he's back.
Yeah. No. I mean, like, when you guys saw him, he didn't make an announcement?
He did have a talk.
Yo, I wish we had the titty cam.
He made an announcement like, you're never going to believe what happened. Yeah,
He didn't say any of that shit. Yeah. He just like, I want to see some titties.
Isn't that
majority that he does anyway? Just like a clown?
He smokes cigarettes through his nose and he wants to see titties.
Yeah.
That's all he's famous for.
Yeah.
But his drums sound great. Whoever was doing the Motley sound, the stadium tour sound is fucking great. Yeah. If you miss this tour, you miss something fucking special.
Yeah.
Hopefully there'll be something else around bands like this jam together and go out there together again.
It's making money in certain places.
They're playing huge stadiums.
It is, but
these bands.
Yeah, I think that you're going to see this, not necessarily the same lineup, but you're going to see something else. Yeah. Hopefully Skid Row gets better with Sebastian Bach. I don't think it's going to happen.
Maybe Aerosmith will do something for the 50th anniversary.
Yeah, they should, man. It would be great. And you don't have to play. Yeah, they play for an hour.
Yeah.
And you know every single one of the hits other than Def Leppard playing some new stuff.
This is a good blueprint for these guys.
Did you get the thing I sent you on Facebook with Kate Bush selling?
I was going to ask if we were going to talk about this.
No, all the money that she made in the last couple weeks off of Spotify.
So it's funny because that's the music news.
Yes.
Right. Or no, the second thoughts. So was about Kate Bush.
People want to know, are we changing our opinion?
No, absolutely.
That's what I said.
So we've had a few people on social media still chiming in on Kate Bush. And CBS News says that she's made $2.3 million in streaming royalties since that song was in Stranger Things. And Ben from Maine said, you guys were hating on Kate Bush long before she got popular again, but you guys are wrong. And then,
of course we are. We have a podcast. What do we know?
Chris from New Jersey said, I tried listening to some of her songs other than Running Up That Hill, but they're awful.
God.
I don't get it, man.
People want to argue with me all the time. Not argue with me, but like, do you still think that way? I'm like, yeah, dude, I'm not going to cower away from this, man. Like,
can we play some of that Stranger Things song?
You want to do
it? No, I just hear it. Why not? We never play any of her music. Nobody even knows what she sounds like. Let's play a little bit of this.
Here's a little bit of Running Up That Hill, and that's the song that's in that.
Everybody knows the song.
I don't know it. Oh, yeah.
That's horrible.
Her voice isn't as high pitched as some of the other crap that we've played.
She sounds like she should be in commercials.
Then you sent us her singing fucking with David Gilmour during Dark Side of the Moon. Was that what it was?
No, it was a song.
No, she was playing it.
Oh, yeah. She did Dark Side of the Moon.
That was horrible.
Let me listen to this crap. Bruce hit the fucking electric chair.
This isn't even a song.
I'm calling it. Do it.
We sentence you to death.
We're not even up to the electric chair yet, but we're gonna.
Since we're talking about like Stranger Things, okay? So they use Metallica, fucking
that was
Master
awesome.
Puppets. So a couple people said to me, "Do you think that Stranger Things will do for Metallica what it did for Kate Bush?" I'm like, well, first of all, let me tell you something. Metallica doesn't need any help.
No.
Yeah. Not at all.
No. Kate Bush has been sitting on a pile of money for fucking 40 years.
But she
owns all of her publishing rights.
Good for her.
So nobody wants it.
Right to her.
Gentlemen. I hate to tell you this. She's getting in next year. She's definitely getting in next year.
In light
because
of this.
Because of Stranger Things.
Absolutely.
Yeah. God. Everybody wants her now.
God. Yeah. Her. I don't want her.
But the guys from Metallica, they knew that their song was going to be used. And it's one thing that I saw, that I read, that during the trailer, they don't play Master of Puppets, but the kids shown played on top of the house playing.
Right.
And people knew what song it was just by
his hand positions
and how he's playing it. Dude, it's crazy.
You don't watch Stranger Things,
no,
Bruce.
I don't.
Yeah.
No.
Let me tell you. there's this scene, ending scene. This guy, Eddie, is a metalhead. He is in the upside down world. People know what I'm talking about. And he plays the guitar and he plays the beginning of Master of Puppets. And it's the most metal fucking thing I've seen in years.
But they probably think this is the most metal ever. And it is. Like, dude, like
the choppiness of how he
Yeah, whoever was playing it did a great job.
You know what? The guitar belonged to Robert Trio's kid.
Really?
Yeah.
No shit.
Yep. That I don't know if it was him playing. I read this week, maybe it was him playing, but it's his guitar.
I didn't know that.
But now, what was it? A Gibson?
I was playing. I wasn't paying attention too much.
It was like Ibanez or one of those dudes. Now they're bringing the guitar back.
Of course they are. It's going to be the Stranger Things.
Oh, it was BC Rich.
Okay, yeah,
BC Rich made that guitar. Dude, but now BC Rich is putting guitar back out again.
I would too. Put Stranger Things on it.
Yeah, dude.
Put a little Stranger Thing. Yeah.
We're going to hang it in the bar.
Yeah, people will go crazy.
Right next to our fish shit.
Yeah. But Metallica doesn't need any help.
It opens some more shit.
It opens the door. There's a kid probably sitting out there. I don't know if kids make fun of kids or pick on them anymore for what music they listen to, you know, because everybody's got feelings.
Everybody's going to be up Metallica's ass.
But the only thing I feel good about is the kid who might be out there getting picked on, like Metallica. He's now the leader. He was super cool before. I was like, oh, well, the kid. Weird Danny over there always liked this stuff. Like,
the kid in Stranger Things is this, like, rebel, Hellraiser
D&D
kind of guy.
Yeah.
And he saves the town. That's and the, cool. The best part of it, he saves the town.
Don't give it away. You can't give it away, man. A lot of people. Well, everybody's seen it.
Everybody's seen it.
Yeah.
Town that hates him.
Yeah. And he saves
That's cool.
It. Saves a town that hates him.
Right on, man. It's rock and roll. So. All right, man. Time for the electric chair. You had a good idea.
Yes.
What song were we listening to? I'm like, oh, this sounds like this fucking.
We were talking about
the Jimmy Buffett song.
The intro of it.
Ryan said, Doug said,
I said
it sounds like a Wilson.
Sounds fucking Wilson Phillips.
Sounds like a Wilson Phillips song.
He was
like,
Wilson Phillips. You know what the best thing about Wilson Phillips was?
What
was their parents?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. So
Shitbag of the week. What's his name?
That was their father.
Yeah,
the one that raped his daughter.
Yeah.
Oof. And then
Brian Wilson.
So he said we're gonna kill "Hold On" by Wilson Phillips. There's a picture of them on the top of the Spotify thing right now, like them now, and the other two are like pretty hot. Like I don't know. Fucking.
They're always kind of hot.
Yeah, I didn't. I don't know how old they are now, but
I thought Carney was the hottest.
I like the redhead. Whatever.
That's what I mean. She was. No, who was Carney?
Carney was the heavyset one.
Yeah, yeah.
I like her. She had a nice face, like the chick from Heart. Remember, they would just film her face.
China Phillips, she's the daughter of John and Michelle Phillips and the Mamas and the Papas.
Yeah, John
and
Phillips.
And then Carney and Wendy Wilson was
Wendy
the redhead.
Wendy Wilson was hot,
yeah.
John Phillips is a piece of shit.
Yeah. Dude, he's bad.
He should die
twice. He's the shit bag of the week.
Yeah. These poor kids growing up, imagine.
Yeah.
They seem well adjusted.
They're in their early 50s.
Yeah. All of them. They're still out there. They're in that movie Bridesmaids. Yeah. That, you know, chicks love this fucking song. Yeah. That's why we're going to kill it.
Yeah.
Do it.
Same had, who gives a shit?
Fuck off.
We sentence you to death.
Man, I'm glad Stranger Things didn't use this fucking song.
We've been here forever, man.
Listen to songs that Stranger Things can never do. Get rid of it. It won't stop playing.
Lord. I had fun on this show, guys.
Yeah, man, it was cool. We kind of walked in with no pressure, and it was good.
About the beach, man. No worries.
It's all about summer.
No worries.
Yeah, man. It's good. It was all good stuff. So that's a wrap on episode 43, man. And if you're planning to take a trip to the beach or the lake, you need some tunes, we got you covered, man. We put together a playlist for every episode. There'll be a link to it in the show notes. And you can check out the show notes, too, for links to our social media and our website and how to email us. You know, if you like what you heard, we'd love it if you give us a follow on your favorite platform or left us a review or tell somebody about us. You know, we haven't mentioned this in a while, but we do have some awesome waterproof vinyl stickers of our kick-ass logo. You can reach out to us, and we'd just be happy to send them to you, man. You don't have to do anything. No obligation necessary.
Yeah, you can stop by McCusker's. We have a few stickers down there still.
You can always stop at McCusker's Tavern at 17th and Shunk Streets in Philadelphia and come in and say hi. Chances are pretty good that Ryan or Doug will be behind the bar, and maybe there's a chance I'll be on the other side of the bar.
Yeah, and maybe the warden will be there with his new tattoo.
Come in and check out the warden's
picking up
new
chicks.
Tattoo.
He's going to have like three chicks on his arm.
Yeah.
It's a new world for Rob.
I'm the warden. When you throw the theme song now.
I'm the warden.
Oh my gosh.
Would, his theme song be like the
No, I was thinking more like Sanford and Son.
The Sanford and Son song.
Oh my god.
Love you, Rob. Yeah. We hope you're having a good time when you listen to us, bro. Right, man. We love you. Guys. That's why we make fun of you.
And we'll be back. We're back on schedule, so we'll be back in 2 weeks with some more insight and entertainment. Awesome. Thanks, everybody. We'll check it out.
Have fun on the beach. Be safe.
Keep on rocking.
Peace out.